have been content with the knowledge that per capita, Canada was already giving more food aid to Ethiopia than any other country. But suddenly, it was not enough. Those pictures reached us at the level where starvation is understood, the gut. We could not look away. We could not turn our backs. As individuals, we had to do something, and we did. For the past 2 weeks, the aid agencies have been all but swamped by the compassionate response of Canadians. At the Saskatoon office of Oxfam and dozens like it, the telephones seldom stop ringing. Sports men and women at Cloverdale Raceway came up with $1,100. The organizer was one of the trainers at the track, Roy Tutty.
I think the little guy wants to reach out anyway. I think it's not always the big guy that can reach out. The little guy, I think, can help.
The Canadian Food Grains Bank hopes to double its usual annual collection to 8,000 tons. One contributor is this depot set up by the Mennonite Central Committee in Saskatoon.
It's certainly a much better feeling to be able to give it than to have to be hungry and be receiving it.
These Torontonians responded warmly when asked to give up lunch money. Similar fasts to feed the starving brought in thousands of dollars across the country. At a lively Montreal restaurant, patrons were sympathetic when David, an enterprising waiter, solicited donations.
Your name and address here.
Okay. I'll do that. Last weekend alone, he raised $1,400.
People are very generous. People are responding. I haven't counted, but it's been very few people who've refused me or felt that they were affronted by being asked by a waiter in a restaurant if they'd care to give some money to people who have to eat.
It seemed that nobody could remain indifferent to the urgent need of those people on the other side of the world. In Hamilton, Ontario, the rock group Targa donated the proceeds from this performance and five other gigs.
Well, we heard on TV and on the newspapers that these people are really starving. And we've seen it really sort of touch me a lot. And like, I had my supper today, so we thought, these people are starving, and so we thought we'd do whatever we could.
Driven by the need to do what she could, Florence Reed, an Ottawa widow, began collecting at shopping plazas.
You'll get one
off. In 3 weekends, she raised $30,000. Spurred by her newly discovered talent as a fundraiser, she's going for $250,000.
I had to do something. I could not not do something about it. I can't cope with that kind of suffering. I can't even talk about it. I can't talk about it. I can't watch it anymore. I just had to come out and do something.
Such emotions have been widespread.